Hello, this is Victor. I'm here with a new painting tutorial, and this time we are going to paint this goblin on Squeak, or this goblin knight. It's really nice miniature. It's from the Warband in Warhammer Underworlds, and I'm going to paint this guy here on camera. I'm going to go for a different slightly different color scheme than the official one. I do my own color scheme. I hope you like it. And we are going to start painting this quick, and this is why I unglue it. I separate it from the base. I'm not gluing, I'm just pinning it with the push fit. And we are going to apply this color on this quick, Gisley Flesh, okay? We are going to start with a flesh color because I want to give a red, a fleshy red. And I like to put this as a base. This is quick, have a lot of nice texture. So just put a thin layer all over the skin, okay, going to the bottom, and this way I separate it from the base to ensure that I do everything a nice thin coat, okay? So I will do that, and I'm back for the next step. Okay, next step, I'm going to use Flesh Tears Red, and I'm going to apply it on the Squeak. I go quite thin because I want that the skin color is visible through the red. Okay, and then we will wait at this device before doing any other step. So just be careful that you don't miss any spot. And normally when I do this type of application of contrast paints on that fast, I use an old brush that I'm not too concerned damaging. Okay, take a little bit of water. Here, because it's I didn't cover that much, and I want to cover it a little more. Okay, and now I will wait at this device, and I will be back for the next step. So this is how it looks like once the red has dried. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this one, Rune's Height. And I'm going to do, because I want to attach it to the base and avoid to touch it. So I'm going to do the belt, and it's easier to do it before attaching it to the base, and then we can attach it, the guy to the base. And we can do all the other work, okay? So I'm going to apply this on the belt. And I will imagine that this is like a saddle or something like that. I will apply as well the dark brown on this part here. Okay? I guess he's using a type of a saddle or... I don't know. I don't think... Yeah, well, the goblins are crazy, so you never know what they do. Okay. So I'm going to apply a thin layer of Reno's Hide, and I'm back for the next step. Okay, so we have done as well with the dark brown, the horn, and the teeth, okay? Because, it will give a nice contrast later on. Now what I'm going to use, I'm going to start working on the goblin, and I will apply Siege Purple on it, okay? So on the clothes. Normally, if you look this one that is in progress, what I try to do is I try to apply purple here. I have a mistake, but purple, I do like dark purple type of cloth instead of black. Okay, so I'm taking this and I will apply it on all the places where we have clothes. Okay, and don't worry if you go a little bit over the armor, because we are going to do this later on in metallic. Okay. The important thing is we cover everything that we think it's cloth. Okay. I try not to paint over the rope that is using as a bell. But the rest, there is some stitches, I will go over them. Later on we are going to paint them in yellow. Okay. So this purple is really dark. It's almost black. And this is what I'm looking for, because I'm looking for a very dark purple that will look almost black, and later on we are going to highlight it, okay? So I will do that for the rest of the clothes, and I'm back. We have done the siege purple, and now next step I'm going to use lead belcher and do all the metallic parts. So we are going to apply this, especially on the armor at this point. This is spikes and so on. Well, we can also apply, or we can do this later. And here is where I'm wondering, this only the ears are not armor, but this is a full helmet. Okay, and then carefully I will apply it all over the armor and metallic parts. Okay, so I will do this and I will be back for the next step. Okay, so this is how it looks like now that we have placed the metallic on the metal parts. Now I'm going to use snake bite leather, and we are going to apply this on the lance and the hammer thing. Okay, I will try not to cover the metallic parts. Normally you should do the opposite, but as I was doing the all the metal parts, I decided to do the rivets and the nails on the lance, so I will try to go around them. Okay, if you cover one, well, we will come later on, I will redo them anyway. Okay, so patiently I will do all this wood. Okay, I will not paint the lance in a special color. I will just leave it like if it's bare wood. think makes more sense for a goblin as an improvised weapon. And we have to go inside here, that is a little bit difficult. Okay, so I will do this, and I'm back for the next step. Okay, next step I'm going to paint the skin, or the parts we have skin in yellow. In this guy there is not much, only the hands and the ears, because I decided that he's not wearing gloves. Okay, and I will apply this yellow. I apply this yellow before applying the green contrast, because I like more how the contrast green is working over yellow. You can use Ideal Yellow, or you can use, in that case I'm using Ideal Yellow, okay, but you also can use Flash Gith Yellow. Sorry, both of them will work perfectly. I'm using this one because my Flash Gith Yellow is dry and I need to buy a new one, because we know I will have been using Flash Gith Yellow. But it's okay. So I'm going to apply this where we have green skin, and I will be back for the next step. Okay, so this is how it looks like now. Okay, I also did on yellow this robe here. We're going to do a couple of more details, and then we're going to go for the shading and highlights. So I'm going to do the two things that we have there, and for that I will use a couple of colors. First I will use Leviathan Purple on the small one at the back. Okay, I wanted to have it a little bit more light purple, this one, but then I will contrast with the yellow of the moon. I will do the moon in gold later on. Something like that. Just checking that I have covered everything nicely. Now I'm going to use Agaros Dunes, and I'm going to do the one at the front. This one I want to give the sensation that is more like, and here you can see I go even over, you don't care too much. You can go a little bit over the stone, because we'll not cover, over the wood, because we'll not cover the wood if we have already painted. Okay. This one I want to give it more like whitish color. I will now use, because I realized these are like small mushrooms, I will use first Ushabti Bone. Okay, any green color will work, because I cover them a little bit in brown, so I want to make sure that they have a nice, I clean them up. Use any cream color here. Okay. And now we are going to take a green, so the warp lining contrast, and we are going to apply this on the skin. If the pot wants to stay open. So we are going to apply it here. This way we apply yellow, but no. This contrast will have more of this lima looking. That is what I'm looking for, the skin of the goblins. Okay, we do this and then we'll do the hands. Okay, I will do the other hand and I'm back. One thing we should not forget, oops, is here under the shoe we have this type of leather part. I will use XV88 okay, and I will put it there. And I will put it I was checking the other shoe, but the other shoe it's much hidden. You can put a little bit, but it's not that visible. Problem is that it's difficult to reach. Okay, something like that will be enough. I will use a little bit of the Reno's height. And now I will wait that this dries because I want to do a wash with Aguacel shade, but I need to wait that everything is fully dry before doing that. Okay, so now I'm going to do Aguacel shade wash almost different parts of the miniature. So I'm taking the Aguacel shade and I'm going to apply this on the armor. So the thing that we have to be careful is the green parts. I don't want to dirten them. It's mainly on the armor that I want to do. Okay, something like that. And all the metallic parts. I will do as well the yellow belt. You see that, because then you will really mark all the texture. And if you go a little bit over the purple, don't worry, because it's not going to be visible. Okay, and we need to do the purple anyway. I will apply it as well on the mushrooms to define well the mushrooms here. And then on the squeak, I was thinking if I will do it, I think at the end I will not. I will go as well over the squeak. Okay, to make it a little bit darker. And to create, to enhance the texture. Okay, so we'll take a bigger brush to go over this quick, I think, and we'll do this part as well. This part and over this quick. Squigson may be one of my favorite miniatures in Warhammer. I really love them. So if I ever do a goblin army, it's because I want to have an army of squigs. Yes, be careful that cover almost everything. I will not will do as well the lance hammer. It's a lance hammer, this thing. Again, almost everything except the green parts. Okay. You can see I go quite fast. Here I want to cover a little bit. Okay, and now we weld that all this device. I'm just now looking that I have not missed any spot. Here, you see I was missing this part. That. Okay, here it's done. Okay, now I wait at this device and I'm back. Okay, so this is how it looks like once the actor here have the device, and now we are going to start painting this quick. So to do that, I will start doing first some details. I will use Ideal Yellow. Sorry, which one? Ideal Yellow. And I'm going to paint the eyes. Okay. Something like that. The other eye. Like that. Okay. Now I'm going to use Flake One Flesh, and I'm going to do the teeth and the horn. I'm going to start with the teeth. I will take some Flake One Flesh on my palette. Okay. And I also have Morphrung Brown and so Flake One Flesh, I have Reynolds Hide and Morphrung Brown, okay, on my palette. So we are going to start first with the teeth. What we are going to do is starting from the top, going down. Okay, and then this is why I have Reno's height. I want to be the top quite sharp. So I'm going to use it. And then something like that. And I can take a little bit of Reynolds height. And do something like that. We are going to do the same on all the teeth. Also the small ones, you don't need to do that much. Okay, and then on the horn, I'm going to work a little bit in the same way. So I will first apply more from ground to make it lighter. We'll do it in two steps in this case. Like a transition step, need to put some more water. And I'm going to do the pause or the close the same way. Here I just put brown everywhere, it's mainly on the base that I want to leave. I'm going to avoid it. And now I'm going to use the just plain. We'll remove it here, it's easier out of the base. Okay, so you want to, what I want to do is to keep like this texture of mix it with a little bit of brown. Okay, and you keep doing the same. I will do the same on the nails. Okay, and you keep combining the colors until you have the finishing that you like it. So over here I went a little bit too light, and then I take a little bit of brown. Okay, something like that, you see it on the side. So we'll keep doing like that on the horn and the palms, and I'm back for the next step. Okay, so this is what it looks like now that I have done the horn and the claws there. Okay, so next step, I'm going to work on the skin of the, and for that I put on my palette Bowman's Glow and Cadia Fleshtone. Okay, so this Cadia Fleshtone with these two colors. I'm going to work to do some highlights, and then we're going to apply a filter of red. Okay, so let's start, for example, from the top. I will put on all these things, I will put directly Cadia Fleshtone. Okay, and then what I will do is I will take first Bowman's Glow and I will start highlighting the musculature like that, and the wrinkles and so on. Okay, I have as well Mephiston Red in case I want to mix a little bit to soften the transitions. Okay, and I work with Bowman's Glow. But don't worry if it looks a little bit too stark at the beginning, because we are going to apply a filter later on. Okay. Then on the lips, I will start applying first Bowman's Glow. And then I will enhance, I will even extend the highlight with Cadia Fleshtone. Okay, and like that I'm going to do all the highlights. you can see here. Okay, of course it looks very exaggerated at the beginning, but later on we are going to integrate all these highlights with the rest of the paint job. Okay. Okay, so I will do this for the rest of the miniature and I'm back for the next step. One thing that I'm doing at the bottom, I'm using just Mephiston Red to highlight the parts that are at the bottom. Here I did a small mistake. If you do this type of mistakes, you can use a little bit of Rhino's Hide and you can clean up a little bit. So at here at the bottom, what I did is I give this texture just with Mephiston Red. Okay. I'm not using any of the flesh because there is darker and I wanted to keep a darker look there. So this way I'm using just Mephiston Red and some parts I don't even go because it's not going to be like that visible. Okay, and then yeah, I just wanted to show that because it was a little bit different than what I was doing before. And again, you want to pinpoint all this texture. This bigger one, I will do it with Bookman's Glow. Okay. And yeah, as I said, I will now continue, but I just wanted to show that some parts I was just using Mephiston Red to do the highlights. And as I did before, I will use Mephiston Red to even soften some of the highlights, not to make them that visible anymore, especially when they are more towards the bottom of the miniature. I want to keep brighter highlights on the top and darker highlights at the bottom. So I will keep working on that and I'm back. Okay, so I have done all these quite star highlights everywhere. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the contrast paint. Let me see if I find it. I'm going to use the Blood Angels and we are going to thin it down to simulate the old glaze, okay? So you want it to be quite thin and you put it over the squeak. Okay? And this will help. And just be careful here not to go on the horn or into the eyes, but that will help. Then yeah, I should thin it down a little bit here. Okay, and the intention is that everything looks, the highlights look less dark. Of course the boost tools or the here you see everything I can go. Also the darker parts will look a little bit more reddish and will make the difference between the highlights and the shades more will make them less stark, better integrated. To take a little bit more, I'm using just water, you can use thinner to thin it down. Okay. Just be careful that you don't miss any spot. We have a nice... Oh, so now I will wait at this device and I'm back. Okay, so this is how it looks like. Once the, and you can see that it looks, I like this shiny or this silky, not silky, satin look. I think makes sense with makes the skin look more leathery. And now we are going to work on the purple. And to work on the purple, I have the next colors on my wet palette. I have Genesteel purple and Chereus purple, and of course I have as well black. What we are going to do? We start with Chereus purple. We are going to. I'm going to just check that I have correctly moisture. And we are going to start highlighting with Chereus purple. So we are going to start, for example, from here. We are going to start doing like that. Okay, take a little bit of water. Okay. And I do like that, because you want to give this first the purple look. Okay, now I'm going to start using Genesteel purple. This one, we're going to be more selective. Do something like that. And of course, then we use Chereus purple. Help to smooth the transitions. Okay. If I go too much, I take a little bit of black sometimes, and I will okay. Okay, this is quite a flat piece of cloth. With some water. Okay. Okay, and I have to do the front. The other thing I will do is I have this Ideal Yellow on my palette, the same that I use for it, and I will do these things in Ideal Yellow. Okay, like that. And I will keep highlighting all the purple. Okay, so I will do the rest of the purple. I have done this, as I have done this one, and I'm back for the next step. Okay, so this is how it looks like now, the purple. And next step, I'm going to work on the leather. And to work on the leather, I'm going to use XV88. Okay. And I'm going to do the next. So I will take a little bit and just add a little bit like that. Okay. And then here. So what you want to do is just adding like weathering. Okay. I do some scratches in some places like that. A little under. Then if it's visible I will do a little bit, but I'm not too concerned on that. Okay. And then we're going to do as well the saddle. Okay, I will do the rest of the leather and I'm back. With the same XV88, I'm going also to highlight the wooden part. Okay, I want to put some more texture on the wood. Something like that. And the idea is just to put some, to add some texture to make the wood look more interesting. And of course, where we have this type of markings or scratches, we want to emphasize these things. Okay. Something like that. Okay, I will do the other side and I'm back. Next step, I'm going to use Lead Belcher and I'm going to highlight the metallic parts with Lead Belcher. Okay, so we are going to take it. What I'm going to do is I want to keep the dirty look But I got every shade gave, but you want to add a little bit of highlight. Some parts. I'm going to add here. And I will do the same on this blade here and on the other arm, but this is what you want to do. You want to add to increase a little bit the brightness or the metallic look of the armor. Okay, so as well on the horn here, towards the rivet. I don't want to go too bright. I will not use brighter metal because I want to give this sensation of dirty. All metal, because I think it matches more with the goblins. Okay. Okay, so I will keep doing that and I'm back for the next step. Next step, I'm going to do some highlights on this skin. And I'm going to use Mood Green. Okay, and I also have Ethereal Yellow mixed with Mood Green. And I have here like a very yellowish green, okay? So I have them here. And we are going to use this to highlight. So first I start with the Mood Green. Just moisturizing a little bit. And I'm going to take, okay, it's, I'm going to put some water. Going to take the mix and we are going to add some accents or highlights. Okay. Now I'm going to take same here. Mixture. Okay. And especially I like to highlight the ears. Okay, something like that, it's okay. Okay, and I have darker green, Castellan green, you can use it. Okay, and now I'm going to use again Flake One Flash, and I will highlight this. Something like that. We'll take some of the dark brown just to clean here a little bit like that. Okay. And the last thing I will do, I will use Zambezi Desert. This one. To add some extra highlights on the wood. Especially where we have the hammer. Like that. Yeah, because it's darker and you're in V88. Here we are. We have the goblin painted. It's a really interesting miniature to paint. I really enjoy it a lot. And I hope you also enjoyed watching the tutorial and it's also being helpful for you. Ah, just one last thing, I was forgetting about that. I'm going to use a retributor armor and I want to paint the moon here on gold. Okay, and I will use the Shader's purple to add some highlights here as well. Even you can use a little bit of Gen Stealer. Okay. And now that's all. So as usual, thanks a lot for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. Please give a like if you have liked it, share if you think other people can be interested, and as usual, thanks a lot for watching and see you again later. Bye! I'm taking shots at the enemy. I'm gonna make it to the top, leave a legacy. If I got something to say, you better let me speak. Turn it up a new degree, bitch, you ain't seen anything. Let's go.